Brooks Adrenaline has been one of the top running shoes on the market for the past 2 decades. We're in our 20th iteration. It is a go-to shoe, which, fun fact, is what GTS stands for. I'm not even making that up. It's really the go-to shoe for Brooks. This shoe is refreshingly uncomplicated. The Adrenaline retails at $130. The weight comes in at 9.4 ounces for women's. For men, it's 10.6 ounces. The drop is 12 millimeters. It's a stability trainer designed for running on the track and the road. Let's talk about the fit and materials. Brooks has really pared it down to the essentials this year. So when we talk about the upper, a few basic overlays add a touch of structure to the midfoot, but it's just kept here to the medial side of the shoe. This iteration of the Adrenaline feels just a tad roomier in the forefoot, and that might be thanks to the little bit of stretchiness that we get here in the mesh. The heel cup has really solid structure to help keep your foot locked in place, which is something that you'll want in a stability shoe, something to keep you from moving around too much. The tongue is well padded, which helps to distribute any pressure that you might get on the top of your foot. If you need a wide size in this shoe, good news, because that is something that Brooks offers in the Adrenaline. It's a much simpler design than it's been in the past, and it has a really nice on-foot feel. Traditional stability shoes will have a medial post, and this is a little bit different. Brooks is using their new technology called guide rails as their answer to stability. The guide rail system shifts the support focus from your foot to your knee. And one of the things Brooks says is that about 50% of injuries happen in the knee. Brooks describes their guide rail system kind of like bumpers in a bowling alley. So as you're running, if your foot rolls too much to the inside, a medial bumper helps guide you to be more straight on as you're running. But you've also got some on the opposite side. And it's something that's not going to be in the way if you don't need it, but it's there if you do. When I've worn stability shoes in the past, if it's something that's really built up there with that medial post, sometimes it'll give me a little bit of discomfort in my arch, but I didn't feel any of that at all when I ran this shoe. The guide rail system is really nicely done. Let's talk about the midsole cushion. Brooks uses their tried and true BioMogo DNA foam, and they also have the DNA loft foam. So it's a combination of two foams to give you a really nice, stable, and responsive ride. The DNA loft is just here in the heel. As you land, you've got that little bit of a softer landing. It's right under that crash pad, and it wraps around the heel here. And then we have the BioMogo DNA foam everywhere else in the midsole of the shoe. The outsole is the same as it was in the 19. You've still got the same flex grooves here that give you a nice heel to toe transition that's super smooth as you're running. If you liked the 19, you're in luck because this one is really similar. Some of the biggest changes, the upper is one. It's really not terribly different, but one of the things is that the mesh is slightly stretchier and we have a more stripped down upper altogether. So we have fewer overlays here and just more of a simple, clean look. The texture of the heel collar padding is a little bit different. It's got more of a corduroy-like feel to it. If you had super sensitive skin, there could be some concern with rubbing, but everybody who's tested this shoe hasn't had any kind of a problem. I think it's really more of an aesthetics thing, but it feels really nice. Still got good padding here. The 19 laces were flat. These are more of a tubular type lace, and they're also a good bit stretchier than the laces from before. The weight of the shoe is pretty much the same. It's a teeny tiny bit lighter. It lost about 0.2 of an ounce for women and 0.4 for men, so not a noticeable difference. The outsole and midsole of the shoe are exactly the same as the 19, so no changes there. Number one, the stability. The guide rail system is really top notch. I found it super comfortable. It's kind of like a good friend or a partner where they're there to give you some guidance and support if you need it, but they're not too controlling. Number two, I really like the upper of this shoe. It's really smooth and comfortable. It offers a roomy fit, that little bit of stretch, and I really like the clean and classic silhouette of this shoe. It's very pretty. Number three, the midsole cushion. The Biomogo DNA and the DNA Loft system are tried and true. It's a nice responsive cushion that people have really come to love. So if that's something that you've depended on, you can count on it here for this shoe. The Adrenaline GTS 20 is truly a go-to shoe because it's got that nice, dependable stability without being too heavy or clunky or stiff. It's really nice and responsive and a comfy shoe. I think you'll really like this shoe if you are somebody who needs a little bit of stability, if you're a Brooks fan, if you like a responsive ride, if you're looking for a good trainer to run on the road or the track. These are all reasons to reach for the go-to shoe, the Brooks Adrenaline 20. If you want to learn a little bit more about this shoe, there's a review on the Fleet Feet Journal for you to read. If you like this video, be sure to give us a thumbs up, consider subscribing, stick around to see more how-tos, gear reviews, interviews, and more from Fleet Feet.